It's Tuesday, and it is 3 o'clock, and time for a little glass blowing at Rosetree Blown Glass Studio and Gallery. I'm Mark. I own this shop along with my wife Brenda, and we are in a very hot studio today. So if we're trying some different remediation for the heat, so if the phone cuts out because it's too hot, just stay with us and we'll be back. You will hear a buzzing in the background. They are actually putting in new gas lines at the studio, and they're cutting up all the concrete. So we try to keep the fans off for the noise, but then they're making a lot of noise with that. So I'll try to speak up louder and clearer and see if y'all can hear me. So last Thursday, we made a cone vase, nice yellow cone vase, and Darcy will pan. Oh, it's Darcy behind the camera there. Darcy will pan over here. This is the vase that we did. It's about 12 inches tall or so, and it looks really sweet with these are actually live flowers. It looks really sweet with the flowers in it, and what I was trying to explain like this last week is that I kind of using this to develop some new lines and new work and whatever. So today we're going to work off of this decoration again. What?
So just so you know, Corey has already come on and said wavy bowl. Just kidding.
Oh no. Corey, we're going to take care of you. We're not going to do a bowl. We're going to do a wavy vase. So the top of this vase will be wavy. I could call it the Corey vase, but maybe not. But yes, we are doing I'm going out of my comfort zone. Okay, for you, Corey. I'm going out of my comfort zone. I like things very even line and symmetrical. So we're going to see where this goes at the end of the broadcast. So it's 100 degrees down here, and we are going to just sweat for you, and hopefully you're in an air-conditioned spot and enjoy what we're going to do. As always, if you're watching, we love thumbs up and hearts and things like that. I'm going to give a special shout out actually to my Uncle Sherman, who yesterday was 90 years old, and just want to say hello and love y'all, and we'll get started. So, hydrate.
I believe Corey's reaction was, what? Awesome!
Okay, and as always, we'll start over at the furnace, so come on with me. And I do tend to repeat myself on these broadcasts because we always have new people coming in, and if I just skip over some of these steps, they kind of wouldn't understand what I'm doing. So if you're new out there, we'd love to have you. We'd love having you join us. You can always tell me, you know, let us know that you're new and where you're from, and kind of get to know who we are and what we do. So this is going to be a three-layer piece. First layer is going to be red, and then we're going to put a hot mix on it, and then the last layer will be clear. This is my furnace. My furnace holds up to 400 pounds of molten glass. It's 2,050 degrees inside. So my first layer, that's it right there. I get a little glass on the end of the pipe. I put build layers onto the piece. You can't just get enough for a 12-inch vase on one layer. So we come over to my area. So you got to keep turning all the time. If you stop turning, it starts to drip. Actually three times in the red, and it's a nice scarlet red, so it's going to give us a nice deep color. Each time I pick up more chips, and I get a nice solid layer of color on the piece. glass up. So you see the chips are starting to melt and smooth out. Then develop it one more time into the colored glass. And then heat this all the way in. So I kind of like this decoration, the simplicity of it. It's kind of really getting to me. Real simple, nice little spin to it. And just adds a lot of, adds some color to the room. So we'll see how I like living with it for a while and if we keep it. So is anybody there besides Corey, Darcy?
Oh, absolutely. Bobby Harrison says hi, y'all.
Hey, Bobby. Bobby's in South Carolina. So this, I'm evening it off, and then I'm going to do what's called an air trap, which is blowing into the pipe, put my finger over the end. When the cold air hits the hot glass, it heats up and expands. And you'll notice see right about halfway down, you see it start to poke out. So it's poking out right here. That's the end of the pipe, and the bubbles start to grow inside. So I have to put that initial bubble in, because it's much easier to blow through this mass of glass than another layer on top of this and try to blow through it.
All right, we've got people checking in now.
All right.
Jerry Lynn is here.
Hello, Jerry Lynn.
And my awesome aunt Tracy is actually watching.
Really?
Yeah. Hey, Tracy.
Hello, awesome aunt Tracy. So we're gonna let this cool off. By doing that, we'll be able to get the next layer on top, and this will support that next layer. If we went in too hot with this, that next layer would heat this up and become really, really floppy. So that's why we wait on this. And my indicator, as always, is inside the pipe is now kind of orange. It'll go through red, and then it'll kind of clear up, and that'll be my hint to go back in and get some more glass.
Michael Crowley also says, what's up, guys?
Hello, hello, hello. So you see I have a nice, dense coating of the red. And you'll see that the pipe is almost this color instead of that orange that it was. So it'll be another layer of glass, another gather.
Pixelating again.
No. Go, maybe. you're sweating.
It's kind of
warm. I'm sure the cameras feel the same thing.
But hopefully that fixes it for you. Let's see. You guys let us know.
Bear with us. I mean, this isn't the Academy Awards or
anything professional.
It's as professional as we're going to get right now. There's another site that a friend of mine who does ceramics is on. It's like, I forget what it's called. I know it's Trone or something like that. And it just goes through the system differently. I don't know how it works, but he's all
something's going on. Can't hear anything.
Okay, so let's do this. We're not doing a new microphone right now. So y'all tell us if the sound quality just changed. So did the sound quality go from something that was really good to something that is not so good? Or is it something that you just really don't know? Does it make any difference at all? So I'm just cutting the bottom and working on that spin. These are called diamond shears because the middle of them is a diamond shape. And I'm going to heat this up again.
Cherie said maybe the camera is sweating.
Yeah. Might have to do shorter.
Thanks, Cindy.
Shorter pieces during the summer, just because it gets so hot down here, the camera just doesn't want to do it.
Well, maybe we should do TikTok then, and we can just do quick little minute-long videos.
How would Corey talk to us?
He'd still message us.
All right, so I'm gonna even that out, and then
thanks for your help, guys.
And then blow it, bubble out a little bit more. Because while we were doing that, the bubble kind of got pushed in. So I'll reestablish the bubble in there. And then we're at the same point as before where I have to let this cool off to get the next layer on top. Does the sound okay, guys?
Yep, they said it sounds good now.
Okay. So we spent $70 on a microphone we don't need.
Maybe. Your phone is sensitive to touch everywhere. Said your phone is sensitive to touch everywhere.
Oh, it's moving. All right, so I'm waiting for this color to kind of disappear. And then get the last layer and get it ready to blow out the shape. So let's get another layer and start putting this thing together. All the colors on, now we're just putting more glass on and it'll shape.
That's a lot of glass.
Half gas. the glock, shape it. Just to even it off and kind of get it prepared, blow the bubble out. The glass doesn't burn the glock. It just rides on a layer of steam. And I'm going to heat that up one more time. And what I'm doing on this step also is heating that middle core back up again so that it can blow out.
Part that I have to duck and dive for.
You have to watch yourself. So you see the glass is getting longer.
Yeah, so it seems that the cell signal is a little unstable today too, so we might be going in and out for a little bit.
heating the pundi, then I'm coming back and hard heating the lip of the piece. And again, this was the coldest part, so this will be my longest reheat, just to get this back up to temperature. By me spinning it, shoulders start to gradually move out.
Okay. You just got a warning on your phone.
Oh, really?
15% power.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll be quick.
We're having all kinds of technical difficulties today.
Yeah, Mark forgot to charge his phone, is what that means. All right, we'll do one more reheat and open. And if we lose y'all, we'll post pictures of the pizza. Tomorrow, even if we don't lose y'all, we'll post pictures of the piece tomorrow.
Corey wants to know, why do you put the moil on the rail when you break it for the transfer?
It has to do with the shock when you tap it. So the shock goes right through the line. Put the moil on the rail, deadens the moil and puts the shock more on the line.
So the moil was the part of the glass on the pipe?
Correct.
Gotcha. Just glad I said that right.
Yeah. All right, so. Now I'm going to heat the whole thing up, flare it out, and against my better judgment, make it floppy. There's no turning back now. So I'm heating the bunny up, and going to hard heat the lip. Stop talking, so well, you can see what happened. It flared out, and then look, Corey, it's five even. It's five even.
That was pretty good.
Flares. So.
So the both of you can be happy with this one.
Right. So that's the piece. I'm gonna take it off now. I did one final flash on it, and I come over here to the crack-off area, and if I put the punty on correctly, it should just take a small, big tap, and then I'm going to take my torch, and I'm going to fire polish that bottom, which came off, with the punty so it's not sharp. And smooth that out. And take it and put it in the oven. called an annealing oven, and that is 920 degrees or so. And what it does is when I put the piece in, it's still, the piece is, has a disparity between the lip and the foot. So what it does is that annealing oven evens the heat out to 920, and I slowly put it on a cooling earth overnight so that it goes from 920 down to room temperature in about 16 hours. Anyway, so that's one of the new pieces. We'll see what it looks like tomorrow.
Corey definitely approves.
Two thumbs up from Corey. I want to thank y'all for coming. We're running out of battery, so we're going to just kind of speed this along. Unless anybody has any questions. Quick questions? No. Okay. As always, we love having you here. If ever you need us for a gift or, you know, something pretty for your house, www.rosetreegallery.com. We always have some specials on there, some sales, and we have the Facebook Live pieces on there. Facebook, Rosetree Glow Glass Studio, but y'all know that because you're with us right now. Instagram, Rosetree Glass Gallery, and always on YouTube, Rosetree Glow Glass Studio and Gallery is where you'll find all of these. Anyway, thanks for coming. Y'all stay cool, stay hydrated. Good to see you here, and as always, take care of one another, love one another. We'll see you on Thursday.